Don't get it twisted. This rap is mine, motherfucker. It's not a game. What you heard is what you hearing. What you hearing? It's what you hearing. Listen. It's what you hearing. Listen. It's what you hearing. Listen. X gon' give it to you. What? Wait for you to get it on your own. X gon' deliver to you. Knock, knock. Open up the door. It's real. With the non-stop pop out from stainless steel. Go hard getting busy with it. But I got such a good heart that I make the motherfucker wonder if you did it. Damn right, can I do it again? Cause I am light, so I got to win. Break bread with the enemy. No matter how many cats I break bread with, I break who you send to me. You motherfucker never wanted nothing but your life saved. That's on a light day, I'm getting down. But won't be the one ending up on his knees. Please, if the only thing you can't steal was came out to play, stay out my way. Mother, first we gonna rock, then we gonna fall, then we let it pop, don't let it go. What? X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. First we gonna rock, then we gonna fall, then we let it pop, don't let it go. X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. He ain't never gave nothing to me. Every time I turn around, cats got their hands out, wanting something from it. I ain't got it, so you can't get it. Let's leave it at that, cause I ain't quit it. Hit it with full strength. I'm a jail, so I face the world like a girl in the bullpen. You against me, me against you. Whatever, whenever, you gon' do, I'm a wolf in sheep.
Yo, what's up, Locka here with a, kind of like a build video, guide slash whatever for Kyle. In the first ascendant, if you like playing like that Giga Chad tank that just can't die for your team, holds all the aggro, this is kind of the frame for you. I also really liked playing like Devastator and Outriders. I played Colossal in Anthem back in the day, so Kyle kind of fits right into that little niche of that gameplay style loop that I like. I'm more of like a support player than a DPS in most games. Yeah, let's get started. First things first, I did just forma him. I put another, we'll get into the mod in a second, put another C slot on him. So his stats aren't great. I had a picture like right now. As you see, I had like 16,100 defense, 4,200 shield, 12,500 health. Yeah, so I might have already recorded this once, but didn't realize my mic wasn't working properly. So now he's formed. I added another slot. We'll get into the modules now, I guess, since we're going there. So far I've added two C slots. I'm going to be adding one, you know. Everything is going to be a C slot that I'm going to add on to him. So with Kyle, I tried going the skill power route, see if I can make his alt hit higher, harder. But it doesn't like feed into it. Like it went from his alt doing like 11,200% to his alt doing 11,248%. So it wasn't huge. Maybe you could try like a tech skill booster might help more than just a general skill modifier. I'm not sure. So I've just decided to go all, you know, defensive stuff with him, obviously. Obviously, you're like trying to survive as much as possible. So stuff like HP, shield, HP. Skill cooldown is very important on him. For his, for keeping his resource built. I'll go over that really quick. More defense. I'm working on leveling this up. Now that I've formed this, I have more room so I can level this up more. I just gotta get more Kuiper, whatever it's called. So I'm just going straight defenses on the actual Descendant modules. Alright, we'll just go over his skills and stuff while we're talking about it. So his main his resource that he has isn't mana like some of the other characters. Instead, you use Magnetism, which is built up by using skills like Bulwark to dash, when you hit stuff, it builds your magnetism. And then your bulwark will build magnetism as it takes damage. Now it'll trade out your shields for its like survivability, but it builds up magnetism also. Now you can spend your magnetism on Spurt. And with Spurt, it trades your magnetism for, or it uses up your resource as you're taking damage instead of it using up your shield or your health. So you can pop Spurt and ram things while Spurt is on to keep your magnetism up, and you can keep this up for the whole entire skill duration. Right now mine's at 16.4, and there are plenty of times where it lasts the entire 16.4. Another good thing about Spurt is right here where you saw where it explodes right there, at the end, the explosion that happens, when it does that, it also, you see at the bottom there, it says allies recovery amount, max shield times 100. So as long as your allies are in that explosion, you can give them full shields basically. They have no shield and it'll completely top them off. So I usually run missions with my buddy, and whenever I hear his frame do like, my shields are down, like he'll make sure he stays around me, because when that goes off, I can manually end my spurt and instantly pop his shield back up. So there's a good group utility there. And then you have your ultimate, which I don't like crashing into the ground like in this video. I just like going face first into the enemy. It doesn't matter what you do, I guess. It also uses up all your magnetism you have built. And the more magnetism you have, the more damage it does. So you want to make sure you have either a lot of magnetism when you do it, or that you're not going to put yourself in too much of a harm's position. Now this ability does a ton of damage, and even in hard mode missions, like the yellow mobs that spawn out in the missions we're doing, I can one-shot them with this ability. Enemies that have the three health states and like they shoot out the little orbs above them and you got to break those, I can pretty much take one full health state with a full charged ult. So it does really solid damage. And then of course you have your passive, which is your magnetism. The main thing also with your passive is, you see my cooldown there, it says basic info, then cooldown 300 to 180. So he has a passive ability that when your shields break every 180 seconds, if your personal shields break, it'll refill your shields like over time, like pretty quick ticking. And it'll also give you lots of magnetism. So sometimes, like in the clip earlier at the beginning of the video, I personally popped my shield or my bulwark just to get it to break my personal shield, because my shield was already low, just so that way I could get my passive to pop off, so that way I could then ult the boss with a good amount of magnetism on me. So I would say skill cooldown is pretty important on him. And then just all defensive. Then like his main gameplay revolves around getting enough magnetism to pop your spurt, which it doesn't take a lot. You can pop it very low, but then keeping your magnetism up with your dashes in between. You can pop your spurt to help your allies, ult for big damage. He is very much a group character. You can do him solo, like if you see like the clip in the beginning, one of the clips. I did do a hard mode mission solo with him. You'll just be very heavily reliant on your gun. You gotta have a good weapon. So he's very much a group descendant, because his kit doesn't really give damage to, or doesn't really like give a lot of damage outside of his ultimate. So for his weapon, I'm using a tamer. I'm working on leveling this up still, or like leveling up the mods on it. I need to use a activator on it, but I'm waiting to find one that's at a base of close to 200k first before I find it. I really don't use my secondary weapons, mainly between ramming stuff to keep my shields up. The reduced movement you get from using the tamer is not a big issue on him, because he's already just a tank. far as my reactors are going, I just kind of put on whichever one gives me the most skill power at the moment. You can see all my stuff is up to 15,000 right now. I guess I would be looking for one that maybe has like a tech skill boost. If I was gonna specify a thing at the bottom, or maybe like a skill crit hit damage, like if this was a higher skill power on all those down there, it would probably be useful. I don't exactly know what I'm looking for yet on the reactors, because I don't know what they have at the moment. I've just been kind of taking the most, but it's been working for me. For my four pieces here, I kind of just want like one or two with a max shield. Like when I'm at, you know, you saw in the picture, like I'm close to 5k on shield. I don't think you need more than 5k, mainly because you kind of, your sheet shield is basically tripled to your like effective shield use because of your passive and your magnetism spurt. So you don't need super high shield because you're basically getting like triple the effective shield versus the shield sheet like number. And then I just want to get a bunch of defense and health. But what will be important for shield is like on this one right here, the MP recovery doesn't do nothing for me, but the shield recovery in combat, I would like to get two pieces, I think, that has shield recovery in combat on it if possible. I think that will be very important versus your maximum shield, is shield recovery, because you need shield to pop your bulwark. So if you're not recovering it fast enough, you're not going to be popping, you're not going to be able to pop your bulwark. So I definitely want two things, I think, with shield recovery and combat. This, like the passive from the thing, like this, obviously nothing is best in slot. I'm still farming stuff, but yeah, so I think for his right side, I'm going to be looking for two pieces that have max shield on them, and then the rest with HP and defense to get those as high as possible. Yeah, so that's my build currently on Kyle. Still a work in progress, obviously, but you see from the clips that I am very like sort of like tanky. Next step will be getting like another, you know, more C slots on him, maxing this out. And then we'll be deciding on what we want to put next for his, you know, for like our next mod that we're going to fit. So, I don't know. It's still a work in progress, but yeah, that's basically it, I guess, with him. Just remember, keep your spurt up as long as possible with your dashes. Get cooldown on him for sure. Maybe I'll find another mod that has more cooldown. Alt, when you have full magnetism or close to it, does the most damage. Remember your passive, and remember you can manually trigger your passive if you want to set up a big ultimate. Yeah. So that's it for Kyle. If you guys like that tanky support build, this is the character for you. He definitely will survive anything you throw at him, mostly. I think next I will probably be doing Enzo, because I am like a support player, so Enzo is also like right up my alley for play type. I already have him. I think he's like level 15 or something, so I gotta finish maxing him out. But yeah, follow and like if you, or subscribe and like if you like the content, because I'll be adding more like group support style builds and characters. Yeah, hope everyone's a wonderful day. Peace out.